We're rolling.
He's certainly interested in it.
Can you see that?
Nobody manages branches like these two.
Oh no. He's gonna go after the biggest one.
Filbert and Maple are busy branch managing beaver besties. They're also ambassadors for a healthy environment. Beavers help fight forest fires, keep our water clean, and create homes for wildlife. But Filbert and Maple have another superpower, finding gigantic sticks and hauling them back to their lodge. Can they manage this branch? Before today's challenge, keepers planted two special maple branches in the marsh. Wetlands expert Shea Fuller must predict what the beavers will do.
Well, I think that they're probably gonna go for this one. I had a little bit of insider information, which is that they like to slide up through here. I know one of the beavers is named Maple, and I think that that's not an accident. I mean, I would eat it. If I had the right guts, bacteria, teeth, I would give it a chomp.
Now Shea is off to meet Zach Shoemaker, one of Filbert and Maple's expert caretakers.
I'm glad you're here to meet our beavers. This here is Maple, and then this beaver behind her poking his head out, that's Filbert.
It was wonderful. They were so active, they were so engaged, they were raring to go. What are we hoping these guys will do today on their challenge?
We're gonna walk them right through our office and out into our marsh pond. They're gonna get to chop down a tree or two.
Off to the races. Wow. It's got that funny little waddle that almost looks clumsy on land, but then once he's in the water, he's like a ballerina. My favorite thing to talk about with beavers is that what they do in order to make their habitat their favorite habitat actually makes habitat for just innumerable other species. 40% of all species in the world rely on wetlands either to breed or to live. Without beavers around, Oregon would really dry out. The wetlands that beavers create are breaks from wildfires so that the fires can stop in their tracks and or animals trying to escape fires have a place to take refuge. They've got so much going for them.
They do.
Breaking chews. Back in the marsh, Filbert has made a beeline for the special branch.
Oh, there we go.
All right, is it kind of success?
That's a good sound.
That is the sound of a happy, happy beaver. He's almost through. Oh, success!
I'm gonna get right out of your way, dude.
Yeah, we'll let Filbert do his work.
He took that down with no difficulty at all.
Filbert has taken down the branch, but it's too big to fit in the lodge. He'll have to break it up.
That one's a problem.
He says that one's gotta go.
I feel concerned about how much of this they're even gonna be able to fit into the hallway.
It's at least 10 feet tall.
He's acting like it's nothing. I'm gonna wager bets on how many trips. I think it's gonna take 4 trips.
I'm gonna say 3.
So this is trip number 2. It's all just happening so much faster than I expected. Oh man, is it the whole tree this time?
Might be the whole tree.
It took 4 trips, but he's not quite done. There's still one segment of that very large piece of maple left. So technically I was right, but I think in order to complete the job, it's gonna take 5 trips. Thanks so much for introducing me to them.
Of course.
I've been watching them on social media for a long time, so I'm a little bit starstruck today. Beavers are having a really, really popular moment right now. Maple and Filbert are putting faces onto concepts that people really need to see to understand, and so it makes me extremely optimistic. The more people excited to talk about and learn more about beavers, the better. Roll that instant tree play.
Next time on the Beaver Branch Challenge.
Here she comes.
They've been waiting. It's a little too big. That's the best thing I've ever caught on camera.